Hi, Stampers. I'm here. Sorry about skipping out on you last Friday. You guys know how it is when our mojo just goes away. But it's back now, so all is well. I am just trying to, do the usual and get this on my iPad. Hi, Donna. I know you're impatiently waiting for your results. I can only imagine. Hopefully it comes back negative, right? At least one way or the other, you will know. You'll get your answer. Okay, so at the top of the post, I have put the hostess code, but here it is. Is it backwards? I'm waiting till I see myself put it on my iPad. If it's backwards, I will read it. Oh, it is. Okay, so it is BHCYXXUQ. There's no numbers in it this time. All letters. I just got through putting up curtains in my bathroom. I had some up, but you know how when you get them and then they're not quite full enough and you have to add more? That's what I was doing. And it's been a while since I put the original ones up. And now that it's time to kind of start opening. Thanks, Maria. We live on the coast, so we don't get the warm weather like a lot of you do, but it's warmed up enough that I'm feeling the need for some air circulation. And so we like to have that window in there open. It's right off of our bedroom at night. And so I wanted the curtains to be done. So anyway, that's what I was doing, and Lacey had a vet appointment this morning, so we did that. She had shots, and then she had a little, we noticed a little bump on her underneath, like right where the mammary glands are, so they checked that out, stuck a needle in there, and checked that out for us, and he said, don't worry about it, it wasn't in a bad place or anything, and he said it's basically like a pimple. So he goes, try not to worry about it. So, yeah. Anyway, so she's curled up over here in her bed. I'm sure she's not feeling too great from having her shots. So let's see, I guess, well, no, and then I came home. Hi, Sandra. And I was looking around on Pinterest, and I kept seeing these super cute cards with a, okay, I never can say this word very well, Adirondack. I did it. Adirondack chairs. And so somebody finally said, you know, where did you get that die? And they said, Stampin' Up. And I'm like, Stampin' Up? I grab my catalog. I'm flipping through it. It's like, okay, it's old. It's not in the catalog anymore. So I was researching that out because I was seeing all kinds of cards using that die all of a sudden. And it's like, what? I want that. So then I was trying to see if anybody had it for sale and what stamp set it went with, because I remember it. But, you know, it was before I started selling Stampin' Up. And I looked in my stash just in case I had it. I was pretty positive I didn't, and I don't. But I'm going to check with my upline, Joe, because she's got a lot of stuff for sale, and just see if by chance she has those for sale. We'll see. So I've got in my first order from the new catalog, and I'm sure some of you, those of you who are demonstrators, have seen all this stuff, but I'm going to show it anyway for those who aren't demonstrators and who haven't seen it, because I'm excited. My order just came yesterday, and I ordered, you know, like as soon as we could order. I didn't pay to have it shipped faster, but, and I've got another order already in that because I decided after I placed this one that, yeah, I really wanted a couple of other things. So they're coming. But anyway, this is the new Lovely Labels Pick a Punch. So you actually get six different designs out of this punch. Or you can layer, you know, colors or whatever to get one label with this design, or one with this design. Or you can combine. Actually, well, no, they're different. So this one is, I believe, a half inch. The next layer, you would use a 3/4 inch. And then the widest is an inch. Pretty sure that is right on both sides. And then to get the layers accurate, I think you have to go 1/4 inch longer with each strip you put in, or shorter. So you're like this one here, if you wanted it to stick out like that does, that would be your longest, whatever length you want your label to be, that would be your longest strip. And then you would size down probably, well, on this one, you would size down 1/4 inch, I believe, and then 1/4 inch. Now, this one looks a little bit different in the layers there, but if you size down 1/4, I think you would be good in each of your layers. So, yeah, Lovely Labels Pick a Punch. And, oh, and then I just picked up another box of mini glue dots because I needed some. And what else do I have? Oh, the new In Colors on the blends. So there is the Just Jade. And now when you get these, you get the 2-pack. They don't sell them individually anymore. So it's $9 and you get both the light and dark shades. So this is the Just Jade. This is the, what is it? Cinnamon Cider. It's a really nice color. I love, love, love this one. Magenta Madness. It's gorgeous. I love it. I like color. Color, color, color. This one is Misty Moonlight. And then this is a new, it's not a new color, but it's new to the blends, and it is Melon Mambo. And it is really, really pretty. So I got those. I think I have all the colors in those now. And, oops. Sorry, I've got it all in a basket over here. So I got the ink pads because you can buy them in a bundle. So that's the Magenta Madness. So very pretty. Hi, Kathy. And Bumblebee. And you didn't hear me say Bumblebee in the blends, because that is the only color of the new In Colors that doesn't come in the blends. But I think it's because there's enough other colors that are very close to it. So, you know, they didn't feel the need to do it in a blend for Bumblebee. Misty Moonlight, Cinnamon Cider. I think this needs us to have music with it every time you say it. Okay, Cinnamon Cider and Just Jade. Okay. So I got those. What's next? Oh, I got the... This I thought was interesting, you guys. I got the refills because if you're going to get the ink pad, well, for me, I get the refill at the same time because it's a smart thing to do. This is how they came, just like this. Usually they are in a little Ziploc bag, so if they spill or get squished or leak or whatever, that it's not all over everything. And I don't know if they just forgot or if they're not doing that. I mean, everything was perfect, but yeah, they weren't in little bags. I thought that was odd. Okay. Cute fruit. Is that cute or what? It's cute because it's cute fruit. It's so cute. I love it. This is in the beginner brochure, so you're not going to find it in your regular catalog. You're probably saying, wait, where did she see that? I didn't see that. It's because it's in the beginner brochure. Look at the pineapple, and there's little faces to put on everything. If you're a fan of Lawn Fawn, you know, they have little faces on everything. And I loved this because they have the same cute little faces. I love that. Now, really, you could make, I mean, that's looks like watermelon to me. But why couldn't you make that into an apple slice if you wanted to? You could because, you know, you could. You could make that into a pear slice or whatever kind of slice of fruit you want to make it into. This could be an orange or a lime. But I love the pineapple. What's that? What is this? I don't know. You guys tell me, what is that? Is that like kiwi maybe? I'm not sure. Okay, so the greetings say, you're one in a melon, wishing you a slice of happiness. I love that. I couldn't ask for a sweeter friend, and smile. And if you're wondering what this little doodah is here, it's just like the thing that's on the stem of the banana. That's what that is for, right? So cute. Okay, let me get this up so I can see your guys' comments. Donna, I just got a big order. Big for me. Oh, I know, it is like Christmas. And Kathy's getting her inks on Monday. Awesome. Okay, this one. How cute is this? Where's the other? Is it in my drawer here? Okay, right in the front. So look, you guys, these coordinate. Under my umbrella and pretty parasol. And then there's the punch that punches out this shape, and the handles. Okay, look how cute. I love this because I love the little lace and stuff that you can, or make it look like beads are dangling down. And look at the design on that. It is stinking adorable. And they even have it for the halfway closed up one. And look at the handle you can put on, you know, like the old fashioned ones. That is so cute. I thought this was adorable. I had to have it. This is a photopolymer set. And since it's backwards, I will read these to you. Thank you for being my sunshine, wishing you warmth and sunshine. It's a happy day and you make the day brighter. I love it. Too cute. Oh, and this one. Okay, I'm excited about all of them. All right, nothing's better than, and look at all the fun stuff, cookies and chocolate and fun drinks and coffee, and they're two-step stamps. I love, love, love that. And there's dyes. I'll open that so we can see them. And this one is photopolymer because it's the two-step stamping there, so you can see how to layer them up. So the words, oh, I love this. Today's plan with a colon, chocolate, cocktails, whatever, cookies, coffee. That's so cute. And then there's you make everything better. And then you can say cookies is like, and then it's like, just kidding, I have no idea. You're just like, whatever, chocolate. And then there's kind of day. So you could have coffee kind of day, cocktails kind of day, whatever. And then over here it says, and I'm pretty sure tomorrow will be too. And be awesome, because adulting is hard. A day without and today is A. So you can do lots of fun things with that set. Yes, I think you should get the umbrella set, Kathy. It is so cute. There's just so many fun kinds of cards you can do with that for any kind of a shower, like any kind of baby shower. You could put one of the cute little critters with it, you know, to make turn it more babyish, I guess. And I don't know. There's so many fun things. Okay, this is the die set called Love You More Than that goes with the stamp set I just showed you. And it's got great words. So if you die cut these out several times and layer them up to make them thicker, that's really pretty. When you put those on a card, or if you want to put them on a canvas or whatever, just to make them thick. You can even do it in different colors and offset it just a touch. This says love you more than, and then you've got all those words to go with it. Chocolate cocktails, cookies and coffee. And then there's dies to cut out the shapes. Not all the shapes, but some of them. So that is fun. And that new cinnamon color will go really good as one of the chocolate, you know, colors or brown colors. I think it's a really great color added to our already good browns that we have. Okay, am I the only weirdo that puts your stuff back in the packaging? I'm telling you, that's what I do all the time. Like, unless it rips or something, this is how all my stuff is. I'm weird. Okay, this set is not new, but I decided finally that I needed to have it because we live at the coast and it's very coastal. And this is the main reason why, because I love the seahorse. This is Seaside Notions. It's just a really good set. I love the sand, but I really, really love the seahorse. And the sayings are, with gratitude, happy birthday, here's to you, and thinking of you. And I thought it would go really well with this brand new set. Well done. Okay, look at that little seahorse in there. But these are perfect together, because these have a lot of more solid-y kind of images, and these have ones that you can color up. So I think they'll be really pretty together. And this one's a rubber set. This one's photopolymer. But look at the cute whale and the turtle, all of it. It's so pretty, which that reminds me, never mind. I was like, why didn't I get the paper? Because I was thinking they were 12 by 12. Because I bought the whole suite of stuff. And so I was thinking I messed up. But no, I got it at 6 by 6 because I love that. Because I think 6 by 6 papers are really perfect for card making, because the designs are a little smaller than some of the 12 by 12 papers get a little big for cards. Okay, this is the embossing folder. How awesome is that? I love this. Ooh, I can't wait to play with that. Look, there's little starfish and everything in there. I think it's so pretty. And then you also get the ribbon, which is pool party. I'm pretty sure. And it's a sheer ribbon. And I love that it has that little, I mean, it doesn't have glitter or anything, but it's really got that sheen to it. I like that. And then the punch. So you can get the stamp set and the punch as a combo, or you can get the whole suite. So this cuts out the main part of the whale. This piece right here, if you're confused about what that is, that does the colored part of his belly. And then this is his fin over here. Isn't that what it's called? His his fin. Okay, and then there's this, the whale spout. So cute. This will also cut out some of the designs in the paper. And then there are sequins. Let's look at them. They're really, really pretty. I don't know how I'm going to show them to you with my phone like that. There's seashells in here, you guys. Let me grab one if I can. These are so pretty. It's pink. I know it's getting too much glare, but oh, there, see? Little seashells. I can't tip them up, they'll all spill out. They're really pretty. There's blue, like a darker blue, and like pool party, and there you can kind of see. So pretty, and they're very iridescent. Let me get some of this stuff out of the way. And I only have two more things to show you, and then we'll get to the card. You know what I love? I love mounting the rubber stamps. I love doing that, putting them together and putting the labels on the ink pads. I just love doing that kind of stuff. Okay, here are the papers. I'm going to cut them open so we can look at them. We had sunshine here yesterday, which we hadn't had in days and days and days. It seriously has been like winter. I'm not kidding. Rain, wind, dark, blustery, depressing. That's part of why I think my mojo was gone, because it was seriously just like winter. And then finally, we weren't supposed to have sun yesterday. Finally, it was a gorgeous day. You know what? I'm going to put my phone up because it'll be easier to show you the papers. Oops. Okay. So it was so nice to have sunshine. So isn't that cute? I don't really want to take them out of the plastic because it's impossible to get them back in. But, oh, there's fish on the back of that. And what do you get? You get four of each design. So cute. And on the back of that. And then this one. This would really be cute with the turtle, I think. And there's like a coral color on the back there. And then the whale. And I'm pretty sure you can cut him out with the punch. One of them at least. Isn't that cute? Hi, Joanna. Is that, oh wait, I'm sorry. Maybe it's Johanna. Tell me how to pronounce your name correctly. And then waves, that's really cute. And I love the jellyfish. We have an aquarium, a big aquarium here where I live, and they've got gorgeous jellyfish tanks. Of course, it's not open now, but if you ever come to Newport, Oregon, be sure after all of this mess is over that you go to the aquarium, because it's really great. We have puffins, we have otters. It's a big aquarium. There's Keiko the whale. Do you know who I'm talking about? He lived here. before they sent him off. Look at the turtles, you guys. I stood outside bawling when his airplane flew over. And, you know, that wasn't a good decision that they made for him, because he was used to people. And anyway, that was sad. But so they took his, where he lived at the aquarium, and they made it into like a shark exhibit. So there's all kinds of sharks living in there, and it's a big aquarium. It's very nice. Aw, look at the cute turtles. These are really great papers. The kind you want to hoard and not use. But I will use them because you get 4 sheets of each one. Okay, there's that. Okay, just Joe. That's easy. All right, so there's that. And then the last bunch of papers I got, these are really super pretty. These are Artistry Blooms. And that looks like gold on there, but I mean, it's that yellow color. But it gives the illusion to me of it being gold foil, but it's not. And then there's really pretty ombre papers on the back sides. Well, and on the fronts of some of these. I just really, really like these papers. Very watercolory looking. I think these would also be pretty with the sea life stuff. Especially that bigger set with the bigger seahorse that I got. I think these papers would be really pretty with that set. Isn't that pretty? You know, green. I was thinking about green today for some reason, and I thought, I really don't have hardly anything green to wear. Do you guys? I want a green shirt, I've decided. Just like a plain green t-shirty. Well, I like long sleeves because it's usually chilly here where I live. I just want one that's green. Kind of that, not like a dark green either, like granny apple green, lime green. I want one. If I can ever find one, I just got to thinking, I don't really hardly ever see anything green. Okay. Here we go. I am using this new Forever Fern set. Speaking of green, I'm going to be using lots of green today. This set is gorgeous. It's got really nice greetings and the fonts are very pretty. It is a rubber set. And there is a really nice coordinating die set that goes with it. Excuse me. Okay. So these cut out some of the ones in the set, and then you get extras here that cut out just, you know, their own design. So what I did was I stamped up a bunch of these in different colors ahead of time and cut them out. But I want to stamp some just so you can see how beautifully this stamp set stamps, because it's one of those, I thought this was a distinctive set. I don't see it saying that on here, but I thought it was. Anyway, I'm gonna stamp it. I didn't get me a block. Hang on. Which one do I want to stamp? I'm gonna stamp, you know, this is one of my favorites on the set. I watched somebody else stamp with this set. Was it yesterday? And that was like one they sort of just bypass. And I thought, really? That's one of my favorites in the whole set. To me, it kind of, it looks like eucalyptus. I don't know what it's supposed to be. But so I'm stamping it out in Pretty Peacock. And don't press too hard. Isn't it gorgeous? Look at that. It just does all of the shading for you. I will, Joe. Thank you. I love this set, you guys. And really, if one of you has a catalog there, whatever, can you look in it and see if it says that this is a distinctive set? Because I really thought it was. It sure stamps like one. Okay, so that was that one in Pretty Peacock. And it's gorgeous. And let's see, how about if I stamp this one in Garden Green? You can stamp these out in any colors you want. And I was thinking how pretty these would all be stamped in, like that new Magenta Madness and pinks and purples. I'm going to have to do that. Like totally not the colors you would typically stamp these things in, but man, would they be pretty. Isn't that gorgeous? I am just so impressed with how pretty these are when you stamp them. So that's Garden Green. And then I brought out Pear Pizzazz, and I will stamp one in the lighter color here. And let's see, which stamp should I do? Let's see, I think I will do, I'll do one of these. I'll do this one. And again, this is Pear Pizzazz. And I'm not pushing down too hard at all onto the ink pad. And then you also, like I said, don't push down too hard when you stamp it. Just kind of sit it there and let your paper absorb the ink a little bit. Hey, Dina. And look. It's so, so pretty. I just love this set. It's almost like you can't go wrong. Okay. I mean, this set is perfect for beginner stampers because you get such gorgeous results. And you don't really have to color those in. In fact, I don't think you would want to. Okay, so like I said, I stamped out a bunch of these already and cut them out. And I have them here in this little tray, which, do you guys know what that is? It is a frozen food tray. I've saved a whole bunch of these and they come in. I used to use them all the time when I was doing parties at my house. Because they hold everybody's, you know, little bits and pieces. And I still have them here in my stamp room. And I use them because they just work so great. And they stack inside of each other. Okay, so where's my stuff? Here it is. Here are all my parts and pieces to this card. So I'm using Whisper White. And this is, what is this color? It is this lightest green we have, Soft Seafoam. And then I've got pieces from the coordinating papers to this stamp set. So that is the front and back of that piece. And somewhere here is the front and back of that piece there. Okay, so this is somewhat of a fun fold card. I've made this design before. And let me get my ruler so I can tell you, this base part of the card is 8.5 inches by 4.25, and it's scored at 3. And your score is, your fold is going to be on the left and come over that way. And then we've got an inside piece here, and it is 5.25. I'm just going to give you all the measurements of the layers by 4. And then our designer paper is 3.75 by 5. That's going to go there. And then we have a little card here that's going to mount this way, and it's folded on the right. So for the little card, it is 8 inches by 3, and it's scored at 4 right in the middle. And then the layers for it, there's one for the inside in Whisper White, and it's 3.75 by 2.75. And then there's the piece that's going to be on the top of it. And I went ahead and I ran it through the subtle embossing folder. And it is 3.75 by 2.75. I think it's the same. Yeah, it's the same size. So you'll need two pieces that size and one of them embossed in some sort of a folder if you want. And then for the front little flap here, we've got 2.75 by 4. That's going to go there. And 2.5 by 3.75. Okay. So really, I think what I'm going to do is put some of these layers together. And then we will have that part all ready. And then we can do always what I think is the fun part, which is the decorating part. So Stampin' Up! Has new adhesives. Has anyone tried them? I always just use my ATG, so, and I use the Tombow glue. So those are the two that I like to use, really. But the adhesives are really handy to take on the go with you. And I have a bunch of the other Stampin' Up! Adhesives, so I'm not going to run out of that for a while. So I don't know that I will be buying any of the new stuff, you know, for a while. But I'm curious as to how people are liking it. I've heard that it's way better than what they had before. My first intention was to use that side. But then I decided that I wanted this side. Pretty. I love patterned paper. Okay, so now let's do this piece. This reminds me of the subtle embossing folder. Look. It's very similar. So what is your guys' favorite, most favorite, number one set in the new catalog? I'm curious. Curious. Now, when you put this on, try to make sure that you are matching it up with the layer that you did down here. I might have gotten mine up. No, it's pretty close. Otherwise, it might look a little wonky. Okay, so that's ready. And then this one. That's going to go on there. I'm not going to glue that in just yet, though, because this is the part that we're going to decorate. And this is the part that's going to have a greeting on the inside. And I think I'm going to actually pull out Butterfly, Gala, or Gala, the pets. Joe loves the pet set. It's so cute. And that was like number one on my list. And then I haven't gotten it yet. Actually, no. The whale set was number one on my list. The pet papers I love. I think I'm going to do You've Been On My Mind from this set. It's funny how, you know, we think, oh, I have to have this one first, and then we change our minds. And I don't know why. I mean, I'm sure I will end up getting the pet set. What color? I'm going to do Pretty Peacock. Hopefully I can get this straight. Let me try to line it up on my paper. Get my paper straight. And then it's a little easier, right? Fingers crossed that we've got this straight. It's okay. Okay, so that is done. And I can go ahead and put that on the inside. And don't forget, this one's going to open on the opposite side than what you're used to for a card, because it's going to sit like this, okay? So make sure when you put your inside in there that you're putting it in there, what I would say, backwards. I really love this card, the design of this fold of this card. I mean, if you're wanting a card that you need to write a lot inside of, you could put another piece of Whisper White on this side to have a lot more room to write if you wanted. Because, you know, just with this little piece, it's not giving you a whole lot of room to write more than really your signatures. But if you put that other piece over there, then you could write, you know, a bigger message. Okay. So that's ready. Now let me bring all my little parts and pieces in, and I'll get some dimensionals ready and some Tombow glue ready. And then, like I said, I just stamped out a bunch of these in the different colors. I used garden green, Pretty Peacock, Pear Pizzazz, or no, I didn't use Pear Pizzazz, or did I? Yeah, I guess I did. Pear Pizzazz, Garden Green. Oh, and I used Shaded Spruce. That's that color. And then I cut some out of the same colors with those extra dies that are in the set. I love that. And then there's these little ones. I think there's like four of these little dies in the die set, so you can just cut them all out at the same time. So the one thing you want to make sure when you are doing the layout here of your card is not to go over this edge in particular, the edge that has the fold. And I learned that doing my sample card, because when you go to open it, you're going to cause things to get bent here. So make sure in particular on this side that you don't go over the edge. You can if you want on this side, but you know, it might look a little, I think it's okay to go over a little bit. So I'm going to put this piece down first. And I just am going to dab. This one's getting kind of empty. Dab some glue here and there. I don't care, you know, if it's not, I don't need it completely glued down flat. Every little bit of it. That's good enough. And I'm going to let it hang over just a touch there. And what did I do on my first card? Okay. So I'm going to do this one next. I can hear a car just really hauling it on the highway down there. Last night we heard lots of sirens, so we turned on our little scanner thing on our phone, and it sounded like the police were chasing somebody. But I think they finally got them to stop, which is fortunate. Okay, I think what I need to do is bring in all my little pieces and lay this out so that I have it the way I want it here. Okay, so I'm gonna put, I guess I don't need a dimensional on it just yet, but I'm not going to put glue down to the very tips of those leaves because I'm gonna let them boink up a little bit. Boink! Okay. Okay, I think I'll do that one next. And I think I will put a dimensional. I'm going to glue down towards the bottom, but I'm going to put a dimensional at the top. And I'm gonna let it come clear over to the edge there, but not go over. So there is that. And then I think I want this one. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna put glue at the bottom and a dimensional up here. that one like that. So you're basically just making a bouquet, building it as you go. I should have put this one in. I wonder if I can I pull this off? Oh, on my first card, this is the one I let hang over, and I ended up having to do a little surgery and cut off the little piece that was hanging over and just glue it back in there. You couldn't even see where I had done it. Okay, there we go. Now I can put this back on. Is that still sticky? Yep. There we go. And now this, oh, I just love that piece. Okay. I'm going to put that right there. Let's put some glue down there. It's gonna go there, and then this one. Oh, and then we have this. Where's this gonna? Ooh, that's gonna go right there. Okay. Now then. Could put it this way, but in this one in particular, I'm going to put it like this. I'm going to have a bow down here. Okay, now then, the easiest way to do this is to open up your little flap, have this card closed, and bring it in and center it here the best as you can. Okay, and then that opens that, and there you go. So even, you know, because once it's centered on here, it's going to be centered once you close that. All right, now then, I've got the new ribbon for the In Colors for 2022, and this is the Just Jade, and it's like a twill sort of ribbon. It's really nice, and it is really easy to work with. So I'm gonna make a bow. And I need to make me another little ribbon caddy. If you missed out on the video I did of those, you'll have to go back and find it because they're so cute. And I've got new ribbons with this new catalog, so I need more ribbon. I need more room, so I need another caddy. And what did I do with my... Here it is. Need mini glue dots, and then I'm going to use some of the new bling that goes with the Forever Flowers suite. There is that. And then I'm going to use the fine tip blue and these new Flowers for Every Season gems. They're so pretty. I used them in the shaker card. Did you guys see my shaker card I did? So that's them in the shaker card. Sometimes the gems, one time I was playing with this and all the gems were like right side up. I couldn't believe it. Okay. They're really pretty. Okay, let me get my take your pick tool here. It's got that stuff, that sticky stuff, and get me out I didn't get one. There's one, but I want a little one. And okay. It does not take very much of this glue. Okay. And then the trick is putting the pin back in. There we go. All right, you guys, that is my finished card. And really, this was a really super easy card to make because if you just take your inks and your stamps and stamp out a bunch of them in the different colors, die cut them out, then it's just the matter of building your bouquet the way you like it. And that part's really the fun part. And there you go, you've been on my mind. And this was the first one I made, so it's basically pretty much the same. Looks like I made my bouquet a little bit different, not too much. And then this one I wanted to put some of those doodahs to a friend that makes me smile. And that is from the set right there. And then there's those little doodads there. I need to put some on this one. That's it. It's like the splatter. And let me get a piece of maybe I can use this because I just want to stamp off one time. And I'm using the Pear Pizzazz. There we go. It just adds a little something, something. Thanks, Maria. Thank you, guys. Yeah, I think it turned out pretty. You've been on my mind. And then, like I said, if you want more writing room, just add another piece of Whisper White there, or you can always write on the back. Pretty, pretty. If you think it needs jazzed up more, you could always take some Wink of Stella to some of the leaves, but I think the little gems give it enough jazzing up. All right, that's it. Thanks for coming and joining me today and looking at my fun haul and being here while I make my card. I really appreciate it. If anybody wants to shop with me, if you spend $35 this month shopping on my site through June 28th, make sure you use this code. Unless you got real excited and spent at least $150, don't use this code, because then you're going to earn hostess gifts and you will get all of those yourself. But up into $150, use that. And you will get a little gift from me then next month. And this is the address to my shopping site. Thanks for joining me, you guys. I'll see you next Friday. In the meantime, happy stamping. Bye-bye.